Hello everybody, it's Marie from Nightomaster. This is going to be a story time, yet again. Since it's October, Halloween month, I'm going to say some stories that really sounds haunting of my bad field trip experience. Let's begin with the one that is shorter, as in the field trip of the zoo at elementary. Remember when we used to have every school and every field trip, we go in the mornings as usual. Sometimes we had to choose as partners, and I end up getting the partner that is who really don't like me. Most people at my school, they don't like me. They see me as the most hated person, except only few friends, like one or two. And I honestly don't know why. It could be my face. I have autism and behavior. Even I strive to be the best of my behavior in school back then. Kindergarten to middle school, it was terrible. It was horrible. When I was in eighth grade, that's where my behavior gets better. So I end up having this enemy of mine as a partner, which I'm not gonna say her actual name because, you know, protect their identities. Let's call her Tasha. Tasha is like one of those people that's those flip-flop personalities. I don't know why they like pretend to be nice and then mean. You can't even tell if they're really nice to you or mean to you. To me, it's more like mean than nice. While we was at the zoo, Tasha asked me to say, "Hey Alexis, can I hold your money so I can protect it from situations?" I was pretty gullible and very naive, so I was like, you know what, sure you can. My parents told me not to do that, but my naive self just did it anyway. I have trust issues. I always think that I trust everybody, which I shouldn't have. And later on, she's like, "I lost the money." And I was like so mad because she didn't find the money and then she didn't give it back to me.
She take my money when I'm in need. Yeah, she's a trifling friend indeed. Oh, she's a gold digger. Way over town.
I'm not even sure if she's lying that she actually stole my money and kept it and pretend to say I lost it and use it up for Skittles and other stuff. I shouldn't have given it to her. After the zoo trip, I was very disappointed that my money is gone. I didn't even get a chance to buy something I want in the zoo. Like, we did not have a good partnership at the zoo. And that's all I can remember. So on my next story, when I keep thinking about the story every time, which I shouldn't because it's very old, but I can tell you guys this as a learning experience. Like, what can you learn from it? Around when I was in fifth grade, my teachers give us a very important announcement that they'll be going to Washington, D.C. There was a paper. They give us a permission slip. It was like probably 2 or 3 pages. It's very important. So they show me black and white picture of Washington, D.C. So I got the permission slip and I put it in my folder. Probably a week later, people were going to the Washington, D.C. And then I was like, did I have the permission slip? So I told the teacher, like, please. And they say no because you don't have the slip. I end up not going with them. And every time I don't go to field trips without the slip signing up, I just act crazy. I'll be crying and basically go insane. It was one time I act like a zombie and another trip I didn't go to. It's not just that, it's my brother AJ, and my dad went. So if I would have signed a slip and give it to my parents that I would go with my dad and my brother, but I haven't, which is the sad part because I really want to go with dad. It's just a tragic event of that day that I didn't go with him and I didn't have fun. They went there until dismissal. After the day of school, I go look at my folder again and it turns out I have the slip the whole time. I was like, completely blanked. It's because I put too much papers in the folder and I forgot that I have it. I shouldn't have put those papers in front of the slip. That's one of the days I really hate the most. I never go with my dad and my brother. My mother, she didn't go. People went to Washington, D.C. again, but this time in my middle school, not in elementary. I finally went to D.C., but my dad didn't go because he has work or other stuff he has to do. And do I have a good trip in there? The same time, it was good, and I was miserable too in that trip because I have so much pains in my stomach, which we're going to talk about later. And there's just some people getting on my nerves at that time. And also, I used to have an aide that goes with me. I think that trip is more of a shorter version of the extended DC trip. I don't know. Because we were on coach buses. And it feels like the only time I was like, I'm happy without the pain is I was in the coach bus watching Enchanted. That movie I've always wanted to watch, like the whole clear shot, but never did. And the last story I want to talk about is the bowling trip. I was probably in either 7th grade or 8th grade, I don't remember. I was having so much pain that I can't even get upright and walk right. I had to make sure it does not sound so disgusting that YouTube will take this down. I have menstruations, periods. Yep, the first early days, I was in pain and I couldn't be able to get up. And I couldn't go because of that menstruation I have, just the same as the DC trip, where I say I'm in pain. And it's sad, really. Like, I didn't even get a chance to do bowling. It took hours and hours for me to leave. I finally went back home. Before I even get out of the car, I end up throwing up in the car. And then I got out the car and throw up again in the sidewalk. I never felt it in my life. It got on my grandmother's seat, the back seat that I was sitting in. Yes, I was in my grandmother's car, get picked up. It was my grandmother who picked me up. Oh my goodness, I did not mean to do that. I just couldn't control it. I probably had to take the pain pills again and then rest. I finally get to share you guys of what's my field trip nightmares are. So what can you learn from it? Never give money to people you don't like. Be sure to not put too much papers in front of the field trip paper. Don't let it be in the back seat. Make sure it's in the front seat and then give it to your parents to sign the slip. And also, be prepared when something bad happens. And that's all I'd like to say for these stories. It's Marie from Nettle Master and signing off.